holiday gadget guide edition of Tech Tuesday. Enjoy getting my tips now since I won't be around next holiday season. I'm Liam Spohr. Number 5. The 5th generation iPod Nano may look a bit too similar to the 4th generation iPod Nano, but anything is better than the square pod, I guess. The new Nano comes in 8 and 16 gig versions, which should be plenty of space for the average music collector. Did I forget to mention the camera on the back? Oh yeah, well, it's about as basic of a video camera as you can get. No stills, no HD, just basic VGA quality with some filters thrown in, just for fun. It's a subpar camera when compared to the handycams like the Flip and Kodak ZI-8, but it's crammed in the already tiny music player and has the most storage of all the pocket cams on the market. Pick one up for $150 in every color of the rainbow, or in black if you're depressing. Number 4. The HP Mini 311 takes the cheapiness and simplicity of a netbook and packs in HD video and a larger screen so that you can watch movies and play games with great quality for only $399-ish. The 311 is most likely to get Windows 7 in the coming weeks, so if you're thinking of picking one up, look for a Windows 7 package. Beyond the HD, the 311 offers standard netbook specs to allow for bearable, but not lightning fast speeds, and light browsing and apps. That does heavily depend on your tolerance to bearable speeds, seeing as any netbook I've used usually involves some head-on-table smacking waiting for download. Number 3. No tech guide is complete without a point-and-shoot camera. The Canon PowerShot SD1200 finds the middle ground between junk pocket cams and overly expensive premium point-and-shoots. For around $130, the SD1200 takes good pictures and features multiple modes for shooting that is a bit superior to similar models. Just like the Nano, it comes in a seemingly endless list of colors, and its slim design allows for style along with quality. Canon makes some of the best cameras, and for the price you are getting a reliable unit. Just try not to link to the more pricey Canons when shopping for this, and get envious of the $499 PowerShot like I often do. Number 2. The PS3 is coming back and it's out to take over your media center. Compared to last year when the overpriced and chunky PS3 was far behind the 360 and Wii, the new slim PS3 is becoming more and more popular and affordable. Yes, I am choosing the PS3 over 360 as the console for the season for the first time. You get a well-supported Blu-ray player and media browser along with a growing number of game choices to suck up all your time during the winter break. Combine this with the Red Rings of Death plague that is killing off Xboxes like the H1N1 victims, and there's even more reason to go with Sony. Finally, the way things are looking, the PS3 will have a longer refresh life, meaning that you can stay current for longer. That's right, Microsoft, I may have chained myself to you with games and junk that I bought for my Xbox, but I can try to save the others. And number 1. These days, you need a flat screen. It's that simple. Last year, maybe you could have slid by with a big CRT, but now if you buy a TV, it's got to be a flat screen. And now is the time to upgrade. There are tons of TVs out there, plasma, LCD, LCD, LED, 60, 100, 240 hertz, 1080, 720, internet ready, iPod docking, the list goes on. Now, if you go get the best TV that will future-proof you till the next decade, it's gonna run in the 1 to 2 grand range. No, you don't need to spend a grand to get a good TV. 26-inch and 32-inch TVs with 720 are easily found for under $400, and they work perfect for entry-level buyers or for college dorm rooms and game rooms. I don't have any specific choices since the situation your TV will be in is the main way you pick a unit, but try to remember that specs are meant to be misleading. Don't think that guests will see your 720p TV and disown you because you're not at full HD, since most often they can't even tell the difference. Smart people, if you're looking for a new TV, be smart. Shop around, read reviews, compare prices and specs tied into your own needs. Dumb people, do what you always do and go buy the biggest TV available or one that looks cool. Now that you have all the info, go out there and get your beloved techies and the family some gadgets they will really appreciate. And plus, you will look like you are a tech since you could find a good gadget. In the meantime, check out Tech Tuesday on YouTube at youtube.com/TechTuesday. I'll see you all next week for the top gadgets of 2009 countdown.
This desk is silly. It doesn't match my decor at all. Look at this.
Attention Tech Tuesday viewers, if you have a desk at your house that doesn't look stupid,